Welcome back to Let's Play Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch, Legend of Heroes, Blind, stuff like that. I am Amethyst Lunatari. We're looking for Chris, and someone said she was over by the armor equipment type person. Oh, you found something? What'd you find there? I thought you... Wait, hold on a second. Pray. He likes being praised. Okay, hold on a second. I thought you found something. I hit the wrong key. So, it's been a few days since I played. I'm just trying to remember where this armorer or whatever is. That's a dead end. Obviously. You're lost again, aren't you? It's not these people. That was the most painful job I've ever done as mayor. Why must we draft those who don't want to be in the army? Yeah, we read this stuff before. Ask people in town. That's what I'm doing. Wait, hold on. What's in here? Oh, it's just more of that. It's a problem. It's like, I know I was there last episode, guys, but please forgive me. I haven't played for, like, almost a week because I've been doing and playing other stuff. Well, this looks like we couldn't get in. Ah! Arms dealer, right. You boy, you're late. I've been waiting for a long time. The password is Jurio the Crybaby. What? What kind of password is that? Chris told me to give it to you. Do you want me to say it again? No thanks. Once is enough. Stand in front of the storeroom and say the password and she will come out. Really? Said the password in front of the storeroom. Got it? Alright, got it. I don't like the password. Jurio the Crybaby. I can't hear you. What? Jurio the Crybaby. Alright. What is with that? Why are you hiding here? Just come in. Pad says, you must be Jurio. I'm sorry to have made you worry. Now, what's funny is that I just got the news that, I know it's probably not new to you guys, unless you don't, you know, maybe you don't follow the news and stuff, but I just got the news that the translation of, Trails to Azure and Trails to Zero, I have that right? The, Crosspell. The two Crosspell games are going to be officially translated as of this time, fall of next year. So, right now it is June, almost July of 2021, obviously when I put this up. So, we've got a little over a year. So, and then the next one, that'll be in fall of 2022. And the second Crosspell game sometime in 2023. So I'll be playing those. Rest assured, have no fear, it'll be out on PC. I'll be playing the PC versions. Like I'll be playing the PC versions of Trails in the Sky. I'll be playing those PC versions probably not long after they come out because I'm playing these, the Gragarv trilogy here, and then I'm going to be playing the the three games, Trails in the Sky, and then right into the Crossbell games. I'm curious to find out, you know, how... I'm probably not going to be done with, I'm going to guess and say I'll be somewhere in the middle of Trails in the Sky 2, or second chapter, whatever they call it. If I had to guess, I'll say, you know, in fall of 2022, I'll be in the middle of the second Trails in the Sky game. That's my prediction. Now, of course, they might change the schedule. They might, you know, the game might be pushed back. But it's really a translation, so it should be ready by then, I think. I mean, the game's... It is done. It's just a translation of the game. Those games came out a while ago, too. You must be Jurio. I'm sorry to have made you worry. I'm Pad. The guy lying down is my partner, Joy. Chris says, Pad and Joy are deserters. Deserters? They were forcibly drafted in Rudo, so they fled to Raguna to take off by sea. Pad says, that's right. We were this close to getting on the ship, but Joy got sick. We are wanted by the army. It's not safe for us to move. Chris says, that's why he stopped me in the crowd at the port. I thought I would be kind enough to help them. Or he thought I would be kind enough to help them. Jurio says, who is kind? Me, of course. So funny, the O's look like zeros. But anyway, Jurio, Joyce, you know, the uppercase O's only look like zeros. Joy's condition is serious and he needs constant care. Oh, Joy is a male, okay? My magic doesn't work. Jurio, can you buy medicine for him? You must be careful not to make the soldier suspicious. I'm counting on you. Please buy medicine with this. I think it's enough, Pat says. If you have any change left over, please keep it. It's our token of appreciation. Are you sure? Can I really keep the change? Yes. Thank you for taking the trouble. 50 piers. Okay, so it's not platinum pieces. Naturally, you give me G and P, especially P being more value than G, and I'm going to think it's gold pieces and platinum pieces, but we have 50 piers. There's no relation to Pier Solar. Pier Solar. Quick, Jurio, we must bring down his fever. So it's not just seasickness, then. I really don't want to be in the army. Jurio, I'll be home soon. Jurio is Joy's fiancé. The two would have been married by now if Joy hadn't been drafted. Thank you, Jurio. If I get caught, I'll be sent back to the capital. Please bring back medicine for Joy. Jurio says, I know the soldiers are scary. Okay, just leave it to me. Thank you. Oh, so polite. Now, Fine controls here. Gotta find a medicine seller person. Isn't it, not them. I just came across her, too. I guess she's actually technically east of here, then. Not this. Right, this one right by the edge of town, I think? Are you the one that sells... Yes. Lena, the pharmacist, says, herbs can have many effects depending on how they are mixed. This may be a form of magic, too. Found something? The bunny. The bunny is kind of... Your pet is in a bad mood. Your pet is weak from hunger. I'm starting to run out of food. It gulps down the stamina food. The pet is obviously showing off. Still in a bad mood. But doesn't look hungry yet. Good. We need more food. So... welcome. Oh, I have to be across the table to buy stuff. Do you have any medicine? You have a cold? What are your symptoms? Do you have a runny nose, a cough, a general fatigue? Fever? Well, give me the one that's most effective. Take this. That'll be 30 piers. Take care. I think it was 50, didn't I? I got cold medicine. Is that good enough? You must get well before the condition worsens. Take care. Alright, so we have... nice, we have 30 piers and 291 gold, or is that actually gold? I'm thinking it's not actually gold. Uh-oh, Fulthia soldier says, wait! Uh-oh. Captain Borol saying, there is information that deserters are hiding in this town. Do you know anything about it? Deserters? Yes, deserters. They must be hiding somewhere around here. Have you seen anyone suspicious? No, I haven't. I've never heard of or seen anyone suspicious. Ever. In my entire life. No. Maybe they are no longer in this town. Sorry to have bothered you. You can go now. That was a close one. Wait, wait, wait. You found something. Too late. I'm in a section here. Chris says, were you okay? I hope you didn't get caught by the soldiers. Can't you trust me for a change? Here's the cold medicine. Jurio handed the cold medicine to Chris. Chris helped Joyce swallow the cold medicine. You should just ram it down his throat there. Ugh. Joy, Pad says. Pad? Where am I? Don't worry, soldiers won't come here. How are you feeling? I feel pretty good. You must thank Chris and Jurio. You could have been in serious trouble without them. This medicine works quickly. I see. Thank you for taking the time to help a stranger like me. Jurio did some nice work. Chris, you helped too. Jurio says, I'm glad you're well, but why did you flee in the first place? Pad says, it's not because we hated the army. We fled because we disagreed with the way Revas was controlling things. We swore allegiance to the king, but we couldn't stand the arrogance of Revas, the king's aide. I'm afraid something bad is going to happen to Fulthia. We're fine now. We'll stay here a little longer, and then leave. Thank you for everything. We hope you successfully complete your pilgrimage. Sweet. What's up, bunny? Observe. You better not be hungry. Bad mood. Doesn't look hungry. Okay. Praise you? Your pet looks somewhat bashful. Thank you, Joy says. We'll leave as soon as I'm fully recovered. Pad says, you and the people in the town protected us, the deserters. We won't forget about you for the rest of our lives. Even we get old and get Alzheimer's. I am thoroughly enjoying this game, by the way, guys. I just want to say that. Loving it. Do you have anything new to say? Don't worry about the two. The two? I'll protect them until Joy gains strength. By the way, do you want to buy something? Should I buy something? Well, we don't really have enough. An intricate dagger with a polished blade. Wooden staff we already have, I believe. A wooden stick which looks as though it might break after a few whacks. Well, we need more P. Lucky Vast. Brings good fortune to the wearer, though unreliable in terms of protection. Cotton robes with a hood, modestly protective, but keeps the rain away. Well, we got these four things. So do we... Will it convert the gold? Is it like 100 gold makes 10 piers or whatever? I'm saying gold, but just because I don't know what G is for. So... Wow. I'd like to get this. Look at that. Attack 41. Up from 29. That's gotta make a big difference. It's up, 2. No, wait, no. 12 for Chris. It's just the vest and the robes don't really do much. Brings him down an MDE. Only helps defense 2 points. Helps her defense 2 points as well. It's just so low, I don't know if I want to buy. You know, we need food though. Although I wonder how much ours. Oh, gores! Here we go, guys. For anyone yelling at the screen, it's not gold. Gores. So we have to exchange first gores to piers. 1 gold. It's funny with the greater than signs, greater than sign. Does it mean 1 gold equals 5 piers? Then why would they put the greater than signs there? So we have to exchange first, it's not going to do it for us. Not enough money. So... Yes. Wow! Exchange complete, okay. So now we have a lot of piers. So I'm buying it in Sight Dagger. Yes, I am sure. And you're very welcome. That's pretty awesome. So, equipment. Well, we can... Alright. So, attack is 29, mat is 21. If I take this off... I don't see a place to equip the knife, or the dagger, rather. That's a silver dagger. Can she not equip that? So why did it give us a screen saying showing her improvements if she can't even equip it? It shouldn't show that like that then. It was like, if you give this to her, she'll be going up from 29 to... I think it was even less than that. Less, not even 29, to 41. I'm like, yes! And no. She can't even use it. Yeah. Okay. Well, it's a little bit of an improvement for him. From 39 to 41, then. Oh well. Now I guess she can't equip the other thing he has either. Nope. Alright. So let's sell... I want to sell something. I want to sell you the regular dagger. Ten piers. Right, I'm not going to bother with anything else. We need some food, though. Chris says, Jurio, let's drop by Uncle Huck since we're here. That famous eccentric guy? If you talk about being eccentric, Grandpa Lap is pretty eccentric, too. Okay. Which place is Grandpa Huck's? I mean, that's the mayor. So you were taking the ship. I hope you have a pleasant journey. I'll just talk to them. Chris, we were so worried after you were gone. Chris says, Jurio must have asked around for me. I'm so embarrassed. Jurio says, but I was so worried because you disappeared so suddenly. I'm opposed to this idea of King Rudolph's, the mayor says. I can't agree with this draft. Okay, then don't agree. Uncle Hawk. Well, I think this is the only place really on this side. Rello says, Daddy is very strong, but I want Daddy to be here with me. Annette says, I hope he'll quit being a soldier and come back. I'm worried sick. Well, that's Uncle Hawk. Okay, hey, you. Chris says, you must be Uncle Huck. I'm Christina from Ragpick Village. You don't know your own uncle? I remember you, Chris. You've grown. Or my brother and his wife, well? Yes, they're doing very well. Uncle, let me introduce Jurio, my childhood friend. Hello. Hello, Jurio. Why don't we sit down and talk? So what brought you here? Ragpick Village is miles away. Have you eloped or something? Uncle, no, we are on a pilgrimage. Pilgrimage? Uncle Huck? He says, that's wonderful. That means you're following the same path the Moonlight Witch took. This must be a twist of fate. Many prophecies and a life filled with unexpected events. I've spent half my life studying her. That's why people think I'm eccentric. But I must find out the truth about her, whatever it may take. Gotch says, I'm here to collect your loan, sir. Gotch. You must pay me back today. Please give me a little more time. I'll pay you back next week. I promise. Sir, that's not good enough. I remember you said the same thing last week. Did I? Would you like me to show you the promissory note? I remember I have some money on the shelf. Which one? Gotch says, well, look on the second shelf, or maybe the third. It could be the top shelf. Is he trying to sneak away? Gotch says, don't you remember? Chris says, Uncle, what are you doing? Quiet. This is just another twist of fate. Chris, Jurio, the development you've just witnessed is forcing me to escape through the back window. See you again. Did he whisper that? I guess he said that in a very low voice. Sir, I can't find a single coin. Gotch says, sir? He can't have escaped. Jurio and Chris say, I guess, in unison, well, I can't believe this. He's gone again. Chris says, he really is a bit strange, just like my father said. Not a bit. Very strange. Oh. Oh no, the ship is leaving. Jurio, we must hurry. Okay. Well, no, we gotta buy pet food. We need pet food first. You don't sell pet food. I know you sell prescriptions. You also sell pet food. Medicine, I mean. Welcome, this is a pharmacy. Do you need medicine? Marbles. Okay, there are 5 piers. I'll buy them. I can't actually even carry any more cure potions. So I'm not gonna buy anything else. I'm pretty sure there was someone here selling pet food. I'll have to find that person before we leave. Pretty sure this is not it. Hawk should get married instead of being so engrossed in witches and magic. Elder Kolba says, I have a bad feeling about this draft. I hope Dursel, who is the best swordsman in Folthia and a good advisor to King Rudolph, will talk him out of it. But Dursel is said to have a difference of opinion with Revas, the king's aide. I don't know much about politics. Okay. Hopefully the boat doesn't leave without us, because we gotta find some pet food. Look in here. Probably not in here, but... Tana says, Miss, I want to show you his face when you were gone. Please, ma'am. I'm embarrassed. What are they talking about? Oh. What's the... Well, how could she show his face? She wants, I guess, wants to describe what Jurio's face looked like when Chris was gone. The translation's a little lacking sometimes. Gomelia says, the old man, a town's arms dealer, is stubborn, but he's a really good-natured person. Everyone says he is always a friend to the weak. Nice. Lagan says, I envy young people. You can trust in your ability. Carry on in your journey. Jalt says, you're really a good match. You should celebrate the reunion with some chicken soup. Hi. Kirill says, the ship I took was very fast and fun, but the captain's face was a bit frightening. It's not easy to travel by ship at my age. I still feel like the ground is moving. What's up? Are you hungry again? Bad mood? Doesn't look hungry. You need to be praised? Because I don't know what else I can do. Your pet looks really happy. Now watch this. Bad mood. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Your pet is looking for something to pick on. What? Get me out of that. I just didn't want to go into that. I didn't mean to scold you. I'm sorry. Ah, maybe here? The chapel master? We sell pet food blessed by chapel priests. Good. So, 50 each? Yeah. Well, I'll buy... I think the only thing we have left is the seafood. So I'll buy an agility food. I'll buy another one. Shielding food. I'll buy 2 of each. Healing food. And stamina food. Please come again. Okay. Now, I don't think there's anything else this way. It's just the gates out, right? And they're gonna let us go out. Or is there more this way? No, pretty much that's it. Okay. We'll see if they have anything new to say. Nope, same. It's a good thing I don't have a dog as a pet. But I guess technically we still are a child, I suppose. Seemed like one. Pilgrimage, Tess asks, what a romantic custom. Loji says, it looks like the Hawk Talon will be leaving soon. I'm excited to travel aboard that big ship. Clum says, a loan shark is after him? There's nothing special. He has never had a steady job, saying he's always busy studying the Moonlight Witch. I also want to travel on a Hawk Talon, Bridge the guide says, but if I go, there's no one to sell tickets. Yeah, I read that part. Captain Burrell says, maybe the information was wrong. How could we not find the deserters after such an exhaustive search? It was not exhaustive enough. Okay, that's him. Okay, I guess we're done. We're going out to the pier. Or the docks, whatever. Whatever you want to call them. Oh, the bunny's happy again. Hi. Hey, pilgrim kids. We're now departing Fulthia for Minarth. You better get on board quickly. Okay. Yo-Yo asks, is this ship going to Minarth? Bosray says, yes. It will take you directly to Neri. We're in time, Chris says. We are on a pilgrimage. Yurio showed the silver dagger. Wow, it's a silver dagger. I haven't seen it in a while. I guess that means you don't have to pay any fare. However, the boy cleans the ship and the girl cooks and does the laundry. If I catch you resting, I'll feed you to the sharks. Hey! That's not fair, they say. Hehe, I'm just kidding. Come, I'll introduce you to the captain. Wow. Hey, you can do your sightseeing later. We're on a tight schedule, you know. Wow, what a hard ass. Captain Jilba, may I have a moment of your time? We have rare guests. They are pilgrims. Pilgrims? What good fortune. Let them come in. Yurio's thinking, he looks scary. Hello, Captain Jilba. I'm Chris from Ragpick Village. Hello, I'm Yurio. Welcome aboard the Hawk Talon. I'm Captain Jilba. It's a pleasure to be able to help pilgrims. Bosray says, show the captain a silver dagger. Okay. Wow. It's really the silver dagger. It's been so long since we had pilgrims on board. You've brought good luck to this trip. By the way, do you know the motto of the Hawk Talon? Thou who doth not work shalt not eat. Unfortunately, you two are not our guests, but pilgrims. So Yurio, you do the cleaning, and Chris, you do the cooking and laundry. For real this time, or kidding again? We thought it was a joke, Yurio and Chris say. Ha ha ha. The part about feeding you to the sharks, that was the joke, Bosray says. I'll show you to your cabin. Follow me. Both of you will be treated as crew until we get to Neri, so you can go anywhere on the ship. Enjoy being sailors. Now man the bilge pump. Uh-oh. I'll give you a tour later, so just come with me. I thought he was gonna get scolded again. There's ghosts down in one of these cabins, though. At least that's what someone said. Yurio says, wow, this is a beautiful room. Let me guess, this is not their room? They have to clean it. Chris says, really? It's so pretty, I'm speechless. I'm glad you like the room. It's a steal for a Class 2 cabin. Hey, Jurio, there's a big bed and a table. Don't you think it's like a honeymoon suite? Doesn't it feel like we're on a honeymoon? Come on, say something. He's not saying a word. Answer me. Jurio is blushing. Basri says, Hey, Chris. Jurio is blushing even at the back of his ears. Don't tease him too much. I'll come back and get you later, so until then, take a rest. Chris says, Captain Jilba has a scary face, but is he really scary when he gets angry? The captain has a stern face, but he is surprisingly kind to children. You shouldn't fear him. Okay, get yourself changed and get ready for work. Or to work. Oh, by the way, keep the cabin clean all the time. That's Captain Jilba's policy. Okay. Here come Logi and Tess. Tess, you go first. You're so kind. Here's Heston. Says, thank you. Take this. Jim the sailor says, are you sure? It's a small token of my appreciation to you for taking me to Neri. Go ahead and take it. Thank you. I guess I gave him money? Oh no, it's the bard and her friend. I guess the bard's name is Sherla. Thanks to you, we lost our chance to steal the treasure and even got ourselves lost. It's terrible. Goose says, Heaven doesn't grant too many talents for one man. I'm already handsome, so a little sloppiness won't hurt. Losing the treasure requires much more than a little sloppiness. You're talking to a beautiful and intelligent lady. You should watch your mouth. Where is she? The intelligent lady. Never mind. Let's get on board. Well, this is bound to be interesting with them on board now. This is not a bad room, Sherla says. Goose says, What a scary looking captain. I hope he won't turn out to be a pirate once we leave the port. Thank you for bringing us to the room. I'm sorry, but we have no tips to give. Well, Lucy said thank you. Chris says, We're lucky, Jurio. Everyone on the ship seems nice. The irony. It looks like we'll have a pleasant trip. Jurio says, How many days will it take to get to Neri and Menarth? 3 or 4 days, if things go smoothly. Jurio, are you afraid of being on a ship? No, not at all. I can swim, so no worries. You look very tense. No, I'm fine. We'll have a long journey ahead of us. It's not a big deal to take a ship. That's the spirit. After all, we're pilgrims traveling across Tirasweel. Goose says, Did you hear that? Of course. Oh my god, they're listening at the wall. Those kids are pilgrims. What a coincidence we boarded the same ship. We'll get their silver dagger this time. But they know our face, Sherla says. Goose says, We'll be in trouble if they see us. So are we going to hide or are we going to steal? Quiet, Goose says. I hear voices from the next room. That means... Chris says, Our neighbors are speaking so loud. Jurio says, Let's go and say hello later. Hey, Jurio and Chris, Basri says. You should get to work now. Jurio, you clean the ship. Chris, you help in the kitchen. Okay. I'm ready, Chris says. I can't wait to show my skills. Are you mad cooking skills? Lucky us, Goose says. They're out of the room. Let's sneak in and steal the silver dagger. It's on their person, isn't it? They left it on the table? She's not saying silver dagger. Oh no. Maybe he was saying it. I thought he was like... It was there. Where on earth did they put it? Shirley says. Those smart kids. They must have hidden it in a place we can't find. Yet on our person. Oh, that boy, Jurio, must be carrying it with him. You think so? Anyway, we shouldn't be staying here too long. We should get back to our room. So, we are going to hide after all? Shirley says. Humph. Pros don't rush. Are you saying we can't leave our room? Shirley says. Sorry, that's how it works. Bosre says, Jurio, why don't you clean the cabins first? There are 8 rooms. Most guests are relaxing in their rooms, so don't be a nuisance. And you don't have to clean the ship's hold. Well, this will be interesting, especially when we go in to clean Shirla and Goose's room. Anyway, longer episode. Well, we had a lot of cutscenes. The water looks awesome. Funny that. Everything else looks cartoony, and the water looks pretty cool. I don't know, it's just repeating textures, but still. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time when we just get in trouble with what's her name? And Goose. I know I just said her name. Nerla? I don't even know. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.